and I'm on the Hollywood Garage.
A lot of awesome talent here at SEMA 2011, but especially my good buddy, Jeff Styles, Pinstriper. World's best. He keeps saying, best, what is it, best
number pinstriper? Number one pinstriper in South Orange County, you know? Kind of a joke, you know, we kind of joked around about it, you know, that, you know, I'm South Orange County. I took it off one time. Everybody's like, man, you're number one all over the place. But the other stripers always, you know, comment about it. And I said, you know what? You're North County, I'm South County. You can have that part.
Is it hard to walk by some of these absolutely gorgeous cars and not think, wow, that would look really good with an extra stripe here or there?
There's a lot of stuff. You know, you can make or break it with a stripe. And, you know, we've dealt long enough to where I always see these flames outlined. And you know, you always call me in to do some striping on because you know that finishes it off.
Oh yeah.
I go and look at some of these flames, I'm like, God, you gotta put a stripe around this. If you don't, it looks unfinished. You know, you like to come out, get to see you, get to see all the other stripers. Everybody's out here.
Oh yeah.
Who's who of the industry is here.
It's great,
you know?
It's really
so
cool.
So you gotta be here. And like I said, to get from one end of this place to the other, it's a half an hour.
Oh, yeah.
It's a good half hour walk. So you better put the walking shoes on and get ready to say, hey, 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 hey.
Oh, yeah.
And then walk.
You know, it's a half an hour. Even if you were booking. You know?
I was looking to get here. I had to be here at 11 o'clock.
It'll take an hour and a half.
Oh, yeah.
If you're stopping every 5 minutes, taking pictures, meeting people and everything else.
Then the other thing, it's like, look at that, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Now I got to try to remember where all these cars are.
Absolutely.
To work my way back through here to go see some of this cool stuff.
So if someone wants to be able to check out some of the work and stuff, where can they go?
SoCalPinstriper.com.
So are you going to stripe any more in the next day or two?
I'm going to do a couple demos, and then I'm free. I'm just going to cruise the show and check out all the stuff and see all my buddies. You know, we went out last night and everybody met up. We'll meet up again. That's what's cool about this show.
Someone's throwing kisses. That's not a bad thing.
Give me one.
Hanging out in the Hollywood Garage, SEMA 2011.
Thank you.
It's real exciting.
Thank you very much.
You know, everywhere we go, it's just people want to talk to Dan.
I want money.
We're hanging out with Dan Woods from Chop Cut Rebuild on Speed Channel. Thank you for joining us on the show.
Thanks for having me. It's great to be here.
This is awesome. And you're booking with your crew.
Yes.
You got signings. You got filming.
I'm shaking babies, kissing hands. No, wait a second. I'm terrible at my job.
You know, it doesn't matter. You can do both. It's okay.
Okay.
But you got a couple of cars in the show here, right?
Yeah, we're actually filming our last episode for the eighth season of Chop Cut Rebuild here.
But the cars are done.
Cars are done. So we're filming people's reactions and sponsors who maybe gave us something in week three and haven't seen the car and bringing them over to see the car.
So is it safe to say that the stress is over?
The stress is over, yes. And now I'm unemployed, which of course creates no stress whatsoever.
This is, you keep your fingers crossed for the next season, which will be season 9.
Yes, season 9.
Wow, you've been around a long time.
Yeah.
Wow, 8 seasons on Speed.
Yeah, I'm like the old guy in the automotive business, and I'm still the only automotive host that can't weld.
And essentially, you're the everyman that is going in to try and build the stuff, and you got all the experts kind of showing you how to do stuff. You must have learned so many things over the years.
Oh, yeah, I've learned to just let them do all the hard work.
Right. Dan Woods, thanks for being on the show. It's been a pleasure.
Thank
Always
you.
Good to see you.
Same here.
We'll be back. From Toyota Tires, Mark Sonsenbacher. Thank
good
you, Mark,
you.
For hanging out with us at the show.
Not a problem.
You know, everywhere I go, I see a Toyo sign, or I see Toyo tires. It's extraordinary how much you guys have immersed yourself in an enthusiast market. People are just talking consistently about the quality and about how excited they are to have these tires on their cars. You guys have some new things here at SEMA? Anything coming up?
Absolutely. We have a new product, the Toyo T1 Sport, that we've launched here recently and we're promoting here at SEMA. It's our one of our flagship UHP summer tires, available in a variety of sizes from 17 to 20-inch stuff that fits a lot of what goes on here at the SEMA show with the customizing, with the vehicle builds. And you know, this is our core market. We've always been committed to the plus sizing, to the performance tires. That's what we build our reputation on. And you know, much to your point, that's our goal, is to deliver a world-class product at a world-class price and a world-class service. There's a lot of good ideas out here. SEMA's always a melting pot for new ideas and new markets. And there's a lot of things we like to see. We like to see what the competitors are doing and analyze that. And we have a lot of opportunity for growth. We have a lot of new things on the horizon that are very exciting for
Anything
us.
Anything top secret?
Nothing top secret.
Okay.
Well, nothing that I could. I'd have to kill you.
Just like square tires, something like that?
No, but we're always looking for new ideas and new fitments and new sizing, especially. With this market, sizing is always key. So we're always looking for new and unique opportunities to develop a one-off type product that sets the industry on its ear, so to speak. Things that I come up with are ridiculous. Our technical people laugh at me and say, what have you been doing? Where have you come up with these ideas? But yeah, we're constantly trying to figure, you know, so many people think of tires as just being a commodity that's round and black.
Yeah.
And in that sense, you know, it's very difficult as a tire manufacturer for us to differentiate ourselves like we have with the competition products. So we're constantly thinking of new ideas and how we can make the next great thing,
I guess. Maybe like
so
pizza smelling tires or something like that?
Well, they've already done smelling tires, colored tires, everything else. So we got to come up with something completely new.